Welcome to the Shikasa Bu Motor Channel. This channel provides easy-to-understand explanations of car mechanisms. Both then and now, hybrid has always meant a combination of an engine and an electric motor, and no one would argue otherwise. Interestingly, years ago, there were hybrids that combined engines with systems other than electric motors. They never went into production, however. Actually, it seems they were never really meant to be sold in the first place. In this video, we'll be looking at Volvo Flywheel Hybrid, introduced in 2013, as well as the Air Hybrid developed by the Peugeot-Citroën Group, also announced in 2013. Since they were never sold, the details of these systems are entirely unknown. Therefore, all the system diagrams shown in this video are based on educated guesses, taking the mechanical principles into account. Please keep this in mind. A disc of considerable mass is spun at high speed by an electric motor. Even after the electric motor is disconnected, the disc continues to spin due to its inertia. When a fan is connected to the spinning disc, it rotates and generates an airflow. Due to air resistance, the fan and the disc will eventually come to a stop. Volvo applied this principle to their hybrid system. In April 2013, they unveiled a prototype S60, equipped with a flywheel hybrid system. At the time, Volvo referred to this system as a flywheel KERS, kinetic energy recovery system. This system was installed on the rear wheels of the front-wheel drive S60. Let's take a look at the structure. To ensure the vehicle's dynamic stability while the system is operating, the flywheel must be connected to both the left and right wheels. That means a differential is required. A launch clutch is connected to the differential via a reduction gear. A CVT, continuously variable transmission, is installed to match the rotational speed of the flywheel with that of the road wheels. The flywheel, made of carbon fiber, has a diameter of approximately 20 centimeters and weighs about 6 kilograms. Its operating principle is similar to that of electric hybrids. When driving at a constant speed, the launch clutch in the hybrid unit is disengaged, preventing the rear wheel's rotation from being transmitted to the flywheel. When decelerating, the clutch is engaged so that the rear wheels drive the flywheel, storing kinetic energy. At this stage, measures must be taken to disable engine braking, such as shifting the transmission into neutral, though it is unknown what method Volvo used. The flywheel's rotational speed reaches a maximum of 60,000 revolutions per minute. Once the vehicle stops, the clutch disengages, maintaining the flywheel rotational speed. At launch, the CVT reduces the flywheel's output to the proper rotational speed, and the clutch engages to use its energy to drive the rear wheels and start the vehicle. According to Volvo, the system has a volume roughly equivalent to a three-cylinder engine and weighs about 60 kilograms. It produces 80 horsepower and improves fuel economy by 25% to 30% in city driving. So, why was the flywheel hybrid never brought to market? Various problems can be anticipated. Let's consider a flywheel with a diameter of 20 centimeters, rotating at 60,000 revolutions per minute. The outer edge of the flywheel reaches a speed of 2,262 kilometers per hour. It sounds unbelievable, but it's true. It's a simple calculation, so if you doubt it, feel free to check it yourself. This is equivalent to Mach 1.8, the same as the top speed of an FA-18 Super Hornet. Because significant air resistance is generated, the flywheel housing must be kept in a vacuum, which requires a vacuum pump. Additionally, the vibrations generated by the high-speed rotating flywheel are transmitted through the shaft and housing, resulting in noise. It's hard to imagine both the type and volume of noise a 6 kg object spinning at 60,000 revolutions per minute would produce, as well as how Volvo managed to reduce it. The CVT also has its issues. The system uses a toroidal CVT, that changes gear ratios by combining four rollers. The green input roller transmit rotation to the light blue variator rollers, which in turn drive the pink output roller. By changing the tilt angle of the variator rollers, the contact points with the input and output rollers shift, and the effective diameters of each change, thereby altering the gear ratio. In 1999, Nissan adopted a transmission with a similar mechanism. At the time, they touted its high efficiency, quick response, and ability to handle high torque. However, due to factors such as high manufacturing costs, the use of a very specialized and expensive dedicated oil, and fuel economy that fell short of expectations, Nissan abandoned the system after just 5 years. In the roughly 10 years between Nissan's abandonment of the system and Volvo's announcement of its hybrid system, and ever since then, there have been no examples of a toroidal CVT being adopted as an automotive transmission. In other words, this CVT system was unsuitable for use in production car transmissions, and the Volvo hybrid system that employed it was not suited for production vehicles either. Whether it failed to deliver the performance they had hoped for, lacked sufficient reliability, or was simply too expensive to produce, the true reason remains unknown. But Volvo's flywheel hybrid disappeared before it ever reached the showroom. In the same year that Volvo made its announcement, PSA, Peugeot-Citroën Group, unveiled its Air hybrid system. They named the system Hybrid Air, but the name doesn't accurately describe what the system actually is. Since PSA hasn't disclosed the details of the system, we'll explore how it works using a simple conceptual diagram. This system consists of an engine, a transmission, a hydraulic pump, a hydraulic motor, and an air tank. When driving at a constant speed, neither the hydraulic motor nor the pump operates, and the vehicle is driven solely by the engine. When decelerating, the hydraulic pump activates to generate high pressure, which compresses the air inside the air tank. When starting off, or when strong acceleration is required, the compressed air generates high hydraulic pressure to drive the hydraulic motor, which propels the vehicle. Therefore, the most accurate name to describe this system would be a hydraulic-pneumatic hybrid. Volvo's system used components that were not yet technically well established, such as the ultra-high-speed flywheel and the toroidal CVT. In contrast, the hydraulic pumps and motors used in PSA's system had a proven track record in industrial machinery and other applications, so they were likely far more reliable. However, compared to Volvo's system, which recovers kinetic energy through regenerative braking and stores it directly, PSA's system, which converts kinetic energy into hydraulic energy and then into compressed air for storage, does not seem particularly efficient. According to PSA, the system weighs approximately 100 kilograms and can reduce fuel consumption by 45% during city driving. In the end, just like Volvo's flywheel hybrid, this system also disappeared before ever reaching the showroom. In October 2024, Porsche announced a six-stroke engine. This system will probably never reach production, or rather, Porsche probably never planned for it to. Why do automakers sometimes go out of their way to unveil technologies that have little to no chance of ever reaching production? It's probably the PR department's clever little trick to make sure no leftover budget goes to waste, I imagine. Just kidding. The truth is, only the people inside the automaker really know. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to the channel. We'll see you in the next video.